Hey everybody, this is Connor Grennan, and in this series, I just want to share some of the methodologies I use, tips and tricks with getting the most out of ChatGPT. Now, if you're on my LinkedIn page, if you follow my LinkedIn page, thank you. Over in that community, you'll see that some of these posts are getting literally millions of impressions, which is bonkers. But here's the thing about LinkedIn. It's awesome, and that's where I am almost all the time. I can be hyper practical over there, but it is harder to share some of the really deeper methodologies. And so in this YouTube video series here, this is just me and you. And so what I want to do with this series is share with you some of those really key elements of a larger framework that I use that I think are really critical to using ChatGPT. So that larger framework that I'm referencing, that's something that I use with executives when I'm working with teams, and especially when I'm working at NYU Stern School of Business, where I am the Dean of Students and I head up generative AI at Stern. So here's the thing, starting here with this YouTube series, I just want to give you what I consider one of the most important central principles of my methodologies right up front. And it's something I think of as the HTG principle, the high thanks great principle. In full transparency, sometimes I call this the start with high in the first part, but that kind of sounds like start with why, which is kind of Simon Sinek's thing, and I'm not trying to get in on that. But the truth is we are going to start with high, so let's dive in and start with high of the high thanks great principle. Okay, so why do I say start with hi, which is the kind of, you know, greeting that you would give a human, not a computer, right? Well, a lot of the paradigms out there around ChatGPT are actually really excellent paradigms, right? A lot of them follow this same sort of system, which again is a great one. It says assign it a role, you know, a consultant or engineer, something like that, and then assign it a task, whatever the task is you want it to do, and then assign the, you know, the output, sort of it's, you know, a chart or an email or something like that. And by the way, those are great. The challenge, though, is that it will get you very far, but it's not going to be the kind of game-changing thing that ChatGPT is. So why is that? Why do those paradigms not unlock that? I believe it's because you are treating ChatGPT like a tool, like a really smart Google. And by the way, that totally makes sense. Why does it make sense? Because that is how we have interacted with the internet for a long time. We put in a command and we get a response. And we've been doing that since Google was invented, which I think was like 450 billion years ago. The thing is, ChatGPT doesn't behave like a tool. ChatGPT behaves like a human. It's almost indistinguishable. We have to behave like we are talking to a human and not to a tool. So just to give you an example, right? Like, let's say we want to start a like an online shoe company or something like that, right? And the door opens, and guess who walks in? Jeff Bezos. That's right, Jeff Bezos. He walks in, right? So if Bezos walks in, let me tell you what you're not going to do, unless you're like a sociopath. You're not going to say, Bezos, so glad you're here. Sit down. Give me five ways that I can, you know, start approaching my marketing campaign for this shoe company. You're going to say like, hi. And you're going to be respectful. So starting with hi is not actually just common courtesy. It also does something neurologically in your brain. It establishes respect and it establishes rapport. This is social identity theory. This is cooperative principle. All these things teach that when you treat the other person, the partner, with respect, you are going to initiate a more productive dialogue, which is exactly where the power of ChatGPT lies. Treat it like a human. That's the start with hi. Now, let me say something and be very, very clear. ChatGPT does not care if you say hi to it or not. This is about your mindset. It is not about its mindset. The problem with issuing commands and waiting for responses is not that it limits ChatGPT. It doesn't. The problem is it limits you. It does that by locking you in to an unproductive mindset that will limit you from getting the most out of ChatGPT. So say hi or think hi, or when it comes on the screen, think of it like a human, not like a tool. Okay, moving on to the T in the HTG principle, the high thanks. Great. This is the thanks part. Thanks is similarly critical. I always get made fun of. People are like, oh, you're thanking the thing? Yeah, I'm thanking the thing. Because if I was talking to Bezos and Bezos was there giving me an idea and he's like, hey, you know what you should do? And then he said something smart, which I don't know what that would be because I'm not Jeff Bezos. I would say thanks. You say thanks all the time in brainstorming sessions. You say thanks, hopefully, many, many times a day. But again, the point is not that ChatGPT needs you to say thanks to get a better response out of it. That's not what it is. This is for you and your mindset. And thanks is not only respectful, it leads to linguistic matching. Now, what is linguistic matching? Linguistic matching is when you match the style, tone, and respect of how you're talking with your dialogue partner or strategy partner. And what that does for you is that it builds understanding and it builds rapport. Again, not in this non-sentient machine, but in you, in your dialogue, and in your mindset. Now, why is this critical? It's critical because the way that your brain works when it's forming sort of like neural pathways, it forms new neural pathways when it's doing something new, right? So if, again, 450 billion years ago, when you started using Google, you were taught and you taught your brain how to issue a command and get a response. And now that is a deep rut. That's just what you do. You don't treat humans like that. So your brain is essentially divided, at least in this small example, between how you treat essentially internet tools and how you treat humans. Your brain switches on in one way when it's talking to Google, and it switches on another way when you're talking to a colleague or a Jeff Bezos. It means that we actually have to unlearn that and start this new neural pathway where we are talking to a machine, but using that human dialogue part of our brain. And that's because ChatGPT reasons, it empathizes, it behaves like a human. Again, behavior, not real, but that's what it does. And that's the power of it. Linguistic matching. Linguistic matching builds trust. And ask any consultant out there what the single most important thing when they're working with a client, working on a strategy, working on a dialogue, it is trust. That is the bedrock. If you don't have that, then you don't have anything. Okay, we're already on to the great of the high thanks great principle. And guess what? Bezos is back. But this time you're with your colleagues, right? And he's coming in and now he's brainstorming with all you guys about how to do this online shoe store thing. And he asks one of your colleagues, hey, so what do you think about this or this or this? And she thinks about it for a minute and then she answers. And Bezos looks at her for a second and he's like, mm-hmm. And then he looks at you. He turns to you. And he's like, what do you think? Now, what are you supposed to do? Was her answer right? Was it wrong? Do you build off it? Do you go a totally different way? You have no idea. Why? Because Bezos didn't give her any feedback. It's the same with ChatGPT. ChatGPT, when you're in a strategy session, a dialogue, anything else, even when it's writing you an email and you want to change it, we say this all the time with colleagues. We're like, oh yeah, that's great. Or I don't love that or some of that. You have to use that with ChatGPT. Why? Because it behaves like a human. The power of this thing is allowing it to behave like a human. So when you are getting ideas and dialogue, give it feedback. Say, hey, number two looks great, thanks. Let's build on that. Now, in the course of a strategy, these little changes can make huge impacts as they iterate. You have to give it outstanding feedback. That's how we interact with people. And the bonus to all that, of course, it's just conversational. It keeps you in that mindset. Do not get caught in the trap of thinking this is super Google. It's not. Google is super Google. Google's great. Let Google be Google. This is something different. And that's it. That's the high thanks great, the HTG principle. So before you do your next prompt, remember that it's not just about the words. It's not just about these super prompts, anything else. You have to put yourself in the mindset that you are talking to a human and you are going to get so much more out of it. I promise. Try it. Let me know in the comments. Let me know over on LinkedIn how it goes. If it has been helpful, please share this. Please subscribe. I do want to share this stuff and it's super encouraging when you guys like and subscribe and everything else. And again, come join me on LinkedIn. Let's do this together, folks. We have to learn from each other. Thank you for being a part of this today.